Look at this, everyone. This here is Rosanna.
And it's the sometimes dog, yeah, yeah. It's a dog that happens sometimes.
Come here, little puppy, come here. Come on, drop it, drop it, drop it, come here.
This is Keith's dog, Rosanna, and she is very excited about this ball.
I like making new friends.
Keith, thank you for letting me stay in your house.
Absolutely, man.
See, you're my friend, and I like you, but I don't like you, so I'm leaving. Bye. Bye, guys. Bye, Keith. Bye.
Sad to leave my friend Keith, but I sure hope he likes his present.
Had a nice rest at my friend Keith's house. Ooh, it's hard to pronounce. Keith's house? Keith's house. Keith's house. Woo! But now it's time to get serious. I got about 5 hours of driving to do today that I just need to do without really stopping or getting too distracted. And we got to accomplish it because we got something pretty amazing we still have to see. I really love Georgia. It's a beautiful, beautiful state. It's too bad we have to blast our way through it here, but because Tyler's here and Keith is here and there's a whole bunch of stuff I want to film in Georgia, I was like, all right, I'm just going to get through Georgia as fast as possible because I want to come back and do some more extensive research, if you know what I'm saying. So it's time to hit the road and maybe have another one of those sexy time lapses while I listen to Tyler's mixtape.
Just like a blind man, I wondered along worries and fears I claimed for my own. Been like the blind man that God gave back his sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light.
Goodness gracious, freedom! Whew, we're moving south through Georgia. We are almost all the way across the entire country from where we started, and that means a heck of a lot of driving that you guys don't see. And my back is really starting to hurt, like my lower back is just starting to get kind of cranky. I've been stopping every once in a while, but for the most part, I've just been booking my way down through Georgia. It's a shame because Georgia's so beautiful and there's a lot to see here and so much history. We got Civil War history, and of course there's like Jimmy Carter and Peanuts and all kinds of amazing stuff. Gone with the Wind, Georgia is amazing. I did get to stop and pick up some of these pickled quail eggs here from a gas station in Georgia, and the lady said, oh, you ain't never had these before? Oh, these are to die for. These are gluten-free, theoretically, so I'm gonna still wait until I'm in a hotel room before I attempt to try this, but I think I might have picked up a little of the flavor of the South despite moving through Georgia so quickly. Another thing is that even though I'm passing a lot of the sites that I know of, that I want to see, a lot of sites where I'm like, oh, I wish I had time to stop and see this, I wish I had time to stop and see this. Sometimes when you stop, you get unexpected sights, an unexpected treat. And this unexpected treat that I'm sitting across from is really fit to blow me away. Look at this. I was sitting over there minding my own business, thinking about pickled quail eggs like a normal person when I thought, that pole over there sure looks funny. Well, this is no pole at all.
This funny looking thing over here is an intercontinental ballistic missile.
Look at the size of this thing. It's really mind blowing, maybe even continent blowing.
For those of you too young to know, an ICBM, an intercontinental ballistic missile,
is a rocket designed to carry a nuclear weapon over the ocean, over to another continent and blow things up.
That's right. This is one of our Cold War era nuclear missiles designed to protect us from the Russians.
See, back when our biggest threat was
the communists, we used to put a whole bunch of missiles on the borders of their countries in our friendly countries, and they used to put a whole bunch of missiles in their country on the border of their country pointing at our friends' countries, but eventually their side and our side figured out how to build intercontinental ballistic missiles, which could carry nuclear weapons over the ocean so that we could shoot Russia from here and they could shoot us.
The Cold War was weird because there wasn't a lot of fighting going on, like hand-to-hand fighting or gun-to-gun fighting.
There was a lot of fighting for the hearts and minds of other countries, like we want these other countries to be democracy, and the USSR wanted all the other countries to be communists.
And because we had nuclear bombs and they had nuclear bombs, we decided it probably wasn't a good idea for us to go to war with each other.
Instead, we'll just keep buying bigger and bigger weapons. It's like getting a bigger and bigger stick and sitting there like, well, if you come at me with your stick, I'm gonna hit you with my bigger, boomier stick.
This right here is a Titan I missile, which was one of our earliest intercontinental ballistic missiles.
Now, I'm not an expert on missiles, but I think that this was one of the earliest missiles that they thought about sending humans into space on the tip of, but I don't think it ended up happening with these ones. Correct me if I'm wrong, though.
I have a really wide angle lens on this camera, and I have to back up really far to get that whole thing in here.
This rocket is ginormous, and that whole big thing would have been full of some kind of crazy jet fuel to shoot that thing over the ocean. That's a long distance. I was gonna say you wouldn't want to have a cigarette around this thing if it was loaded, but clearly somebody did not care. Also was a litterer, so double shame.
Don't you know this thing could explode?
According to the sign here, this thing was dismantled in California and shipped all the way out here to Cordell, Georgia, which, as I understand it, is the closest interstate town to where Jimmy Carter lives, so this is Jimmy Carter's neighbor.
Apparently, John S. Pate Jr. of the Rotary Club just really, really, really wanted one.
I guess the intention was to bring tourists to Cordell, but I don't think it's working.
This diagram right here shows how this would all be full of fuel and there were all these multi-stages. I think this is one of the first multi-stage ICBMs where there were different sections of fuel. Like this part would launch, this part would launch, this part, and this is the part that would come back into Earth with the boom boom.
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you telling me this sucker is nuclear?
No, this sucker's electrical! But I need a nuclear reaction to generate the 1.21 gigawatts of electricity I need!
1.21 gigawatts? 1.21 gigawatts?
I mean, obviously at the moment there's no nuclear warhead on this thing anymore, but still.
You basically have a nuclear missile sitting here at the gas and go. Maybe it's just here in case they need to fuel it up. But wait a minute. Why would Georgia need to fuel up a Titan missile?
You don't think? It couldn't be possible that—
Oh, no. You guys, look what it says up here. Look what it says at the top. This is the site of Confederate Air Force Pad number one. Confederate Air Force Pad? Confederate Air Force Pad?
You mean the Confederates have intercontinental ballistic missiles now?
Oh no. Who do we tell? Who do we tell about this? Tyler kept saying the South would rise again, but I wouldn't listen. I didn't think he meant the South would rise again with nuclear missiles. I thought he meant barbecue sauce.
Oh, this is big. This is bigger than all of us. This is huge.
I think we really need to rethink the way that we treat the American South. Just make sure to laugh at all of Jeff Foxworthy's jokes.
I know what to do. Tyler will help us. Hey, hello, Tyler?
Buddy, my good friend. Remember that time that I brought you a Mexican large hat and everything? Well, we're friends, right? Yeah, well, I noticed that the Confederacy now has nuclear capabilities. I didn't know if you know. Oh, you did know. Oh, you did know. Oh, you're on the committee. Well, what about, yeah, well, I was just wondering about the sometimes mob, you know, and me. Oh, okay. No, okay. No, I know you're busy. Okay. All right. Love you too, buddy. Huh? Okay. Don't worry, guys. Tyler says they'll only use it if they have to, which is, let's get out of Georgia.
Nice and slow. Don't want to draw any attention to ourselves, but maybe it's time we headed a little farther south.
Dang, I forgot to get gas back there. Maybe I can get some right here.
Plantation house.
Nothing weird about that.
But look at this. The world's oldest operating gas pumps. Probably not literally, but hey, you never know.
Dang, would you take a look at that? That is pretty cool, honestly. You know, I was telling my friend Keith that I wish I had time to stop and see some old plantations or something while I was in the South, and I guess I got my wish.
Not exactly the way I pictured it, but I got my wish.
So, Yeah.
Wow, this place is awesome.
I wasn't expecting all this.
So much reading material here. I think I need these. There are more frogs here than I was expecting. I mean, I was expecting some frogs.
Just not this much. Also, that's Let It Go on the radio. I'm never gonna get away from that song, am I?
There's some pretty good signs in here. I like that one.
Aww.
What?
Ooh, hey, careful now.
Hillbilly cell phone. Let's see here. What?
There's a lot of real cool stuff in here. I don't know what I should or shouldn't buy. I'm in a real jam. Oh, that's jelly.
Hey, but at least most of it's gluten-free. Up there they are. Here's where they've been keeping all the pecans.
Ooh,
and the peanuts.
I was totally gonna get me some pecans, but they're $25, so it looks like I'm gonna get some peanuts, which was totally my first choice anyway, so.
I'm not a huge fan of Jimmy Carter, but you gotta support your local farmers. Even if they did wear a sweater in the White House.
Need this.
Also, I need this. That's important. Thank you, man. You too.
All right. That's the most fun I've had on a plantation since the Haunted Mansion.
For serious, though, Georgia. It's been nice seeing you.
Real nice, in fact. But now we actually have to be moving on. Down the old dusty trail. Southbound to
Florida, Florida.
We are now officially in Florida.
And we need to get off the highway right now.
Oh, wow! Florida! We did it! We did it all the way from California to Florida! A Cali-Florida victory! Look at that! The Sunshine State!
Some rest area welcome centers can be skipped, but the Florida one is absolutely essential.
Because not only can you take a fun pic with a dolphin over there, but if you come inside the welcome center, you get free orange juice!
Oh no!
Oh no!
Dang it! It's 8 p.m. The free orange juice is closed.
Well, I guess I can afford my own orange juice.
At least I still get a fun pic with this guy, huh?
Don't touch me.
Okay.
Well, either way, we made it to Florida. I have driven from California to Florida by myself with all of you guys as passengers, and tomorrow we are going to realize the vision from the beginning of this quest to go from coast to coast, Pacific Ocean to Atlantic Ocean. So for now, I better find a hotel and sleep well.
Make sure to subscribe and check out my shirts, livefastdiepoor.spreadshirt.com.
That's right, sexy t-shirts and hats, livefastdiepoor.spreadshirt.com. I also have a patreon.com/justinscard, Twitter justinscard, Instagram livefastdiepoor. I just Instagrammed a picture of this sign and other things. So for now, I hotel and sleep well. I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Too bad.
Alright.
Don't think I forgot.
Pickled quail eggs. Ingredients: quail eggs, water, vinegar, salt, jalapenos, garlic, black pepper, and cayenne.
If I find out this isn't really a southern thing, I'm gonna be super bummed.
Okay. Here we go. Oh, that is a smell for the ages. Okay, here we go. A pickled quail egg. I'm about to become a real southerner.
Oh, oh, it's hot. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, 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 that's the spiciest. I eat jalapenos all the time. I eat cayenne pepper all the time. Like Tony Chachet's, Cajun seasoning, all that stuff. This is the spiciest thing I've ever eaten in my life.
Why did I just put a second one in my mouth? I don't even want this, but it's so hot. Okay. I'm gonna go find some water. If I'm still alive tomorrow, we'll know that I'm not dead.
I did my duty. Go home and sleep well.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, Florida, the Sunshine State, the state of orange juice that you can't have.